I wonder, Daryl's gonna go first. Okay. My opponent logging down, which is great for me. What is he playing? Oh, hate bears. Alright, this is gonna be pretty nasty. How frustrating. Yeah, that's fair enough. Taking away the lightning bolt. I should probably kill his Tidehold Scholar. Since it'll stem the bleeding a bit and it basically gain I deal 5 to gain 5. Okay, no, I deal 3 to gain 3, so it's okay. Was this? Well, that's frustrating. Oh, I did my upkeep, that was a mistake. Not Finks, not Finks, not Finks. Okay, that's okay. So I needed an answer for his Tidehold Scholar. I'm pretty sure he's a flick of wisp in his hand. I kind of want to use lightning helix on his Scarlet, but doing so is just too risky. Got me. Ah, jeez. I misplayed really badly though. Okay, Anger the Gods good here. Path is good here. The Flaking Palm is okay, it's not the greatest card in the world. Nah, I think this is fine. That previous game, what I should have done was waited for my draw step, but because I didn't, I missed out. Wasteland Strangler, yep, that's fine. Annoying, but fine. It's got another temple, which means it's Fortnite State of Time. No, it's just a strength. Oh, it is Fortnite State. Taking away Lightning Bolt. It also means that the Flecking Palms are actually a good spell in this matchup. Ugh, Displacer. Wait, why do you take damage for? I'm away from the cast this Displacer first. Or if he attacks with his Fortnite Sphere, I'll block. Okay, now I'm almost certain he has a Flick Wisp in his hand. This is still worth the play though. Because I get the draw card if he flickers it. And he has to pay up one life to do it. Bring him down to one. Oh, that's annoying. Yep. He might actually break his own land for planes. That would not be a bad play. Yeah, okay, that makes a lot of sense. This is probably for either Collective Brutality or another Blessing. Just that? That doesn't seem to be worth it. Oh, this sucks. Probably shouldn't have played the land though. Smasher? Finally. Okay, now I'm on the draw. Does that mean I play, yeah, I think it does. Deflecting Palms. Bloodhand. I'm not sure, Bloodhand's gonna be pretty hard to cast. I could go with the, Revs so I can hit his, his Aether Vials and his Tile Scholars with them. That doesn't seem so bad. No, I think I'll be happier with Anti-Life Beam Spells. A 4 lander. But I have Searing Blaze and okay, I can keep this. Drawing that fifth land is really bad. Drawing that 6 lands really bad. But that doesn't help. There goes my Searing Blaze. If I'm lucky, I'll just top deck my Anger to Gods and go from there. He took my path for some reason. I'll take it back. I don't really need my mana because I have so much of it. He really doesn't like Pop, does he? Well, I have to kill this place, otherwise I'll keep bouncing his Tiled Scholar. Yeah, no choice here. Drawing 7 lands is really bad though. I basically have not missed a single land drop yet. I can afford to path his Tile Scholar now. Because that's a tight halving his flicker wisp down. It was way too much damage for me to keep alive. Well, that sucks. You're probably gonna lose this though. It's a shame because game one I misplayed my loss pretty badly. Not a bad draw. But there's no reason to path the Guardian. It's something which I can't afford to race, surprisingly. Is it another persecution? So I have on a 3-turn clock to draw one burn spell. Turn clock. Alrighty, I have to kill this creature then. Well, actually, no, I'll let him swing. I'll see what I draw. It's fine. Freaking great. I have to kill this creature now. I can't cast a spell. Because he hit my two lands. Thank goodness, I'm still alive. Okay, top deck time. And I got there.